I'm Christy Paul.
I'm Victor Blackwell. Good morning to you.
So there are world leaders this morning condemning President Trump for calling African nations shitholes during a bipartisan meeting on immigration reform this week.
But he did not stop there. He singled out Haiti in the meeting, telling lawmakers that immigrants from that Caribbean nation should be left out of any immigration deal, saying, why do we need more Haitians? Take them out. This morning, the Haitian Americans in the community in Florida especially are reacting. Here's CNN's Kaylee Hartung.
I'm running to be president of all Americans. That's everybody. And whether you vote for me or you don't vote for me, I really want to be your greatest champion, and I will be your champion.
That was then candidate Donald Trump, speaking in Miami's Little Haiti neighborhood just months before the 2016 presidential election.
The Haitian people deserve better, and that's what I intend to give them. I will give them better.
But in the wake of reports that the president complained about immigrants coming from, quote, shithole countries, among other disparaging comments, residents here in the largest Haitian community in the U.S. agree. They deserve better.
When I just read it, I felt so outraged, but also so sad. I cried.
Farrah LaRue, a Haitian living in Miami under temporary protected status, or TPS, gave candidate Trump the benefit of the doubt and took him at his word. But she said the president has now shown his true colors.
So this is how he treats us. So we can see that now we're seeing the real face of Donald Trump, and this is a face of hate, of racism. The life of
immigrants. LaRue is one of the more than 20,000 Haitians living in South Florida now facing deportation after the Trump administration announced it would end the country's TPS status.
And the Senate.
Trump reportedly made the demeaning comment during immigration policy negotiations on Thursday. He has denied saying anything derogatory about Haitians. In a tweet Friday morning, he claimed that he had a, quote, wonderful relationship with them.
You're telling me that you have a great relationship with Haitian people? How is that possible?
Little Haiti came out in mass on Friday, an event originally intended to commemorate the 8th anniversary of the earthquake that devastated the island nation and killed as many as 300,000. But with the president's slur still fresh, a solemn memorial at times resembled an anti-Trump rally.
We are here to tell President Trump Haiti is not what he called it. Haiti is a proud nation.
We shall overcome.
For the American president, who said he would be Haiti's greatest champion, by the way, to stand up and make such a comment at this time, it just leaves me reeling. It leaves me angry. It leaves me offended. It leaves me hurt. And it leaves me wanting justice.
Justice, perhaps, to be delivered at the ballot box.
I'm going to make sure that we work to remember what he said in the midterm elections of this year, 2018, and clearly we will not have short memories in 2020.
Kaylee Hartung, CNN, Miami.
And let's start right there, 2018-2020. Paris Dunard, CNN political commentator and member of President Trump's advisory board, is with us this morning. Paris, good morning to you.
Hi, good morning.
All right, so you've got millions of African immigrants, hundreds of thousands of Haitian Americans in this country, American-born blacks offended by the comments from the president. What does this mean for your party?
Well, what this means for the Republican Party is that we've got to do what the original intent of that meeting was about, which is to get to the bottom of the immigration system and put together a positive policy that is putting America first, securing our borders, and fixing this DACA issue. So for the party, moving into 2018, we've got to show the American people that we heard them, we hear them, and that we are serious about fixing the illegal immigration problem, one, and two, putting that so the Congress can finally do their job and do something about DACA. That is what the party has to do. We've got to get back on focus, back on message about fixing this issue once and for all.
So a legislative fix will certainly, and I'm sure everybody hopes that it happens before the government runs out of money so that the U.S. government does not shut down. But the damage created by the president's comments, the characterization of African nations as shithole countries, or saying, why do, or asking, why do we need more Haitians? Take them out. What that means for the party. There's the damage created by the rhetoric aside from the policy. How does the president fix that if he's not even acknowledging that he said it?
Well, I think, you know, if you go to the sentiment about Haiti, I think, and I guess we all wish we were in the room to hear context and hear all of what was going on and see how it was proposed to him. But if someone mentioned Haiti as being added to this and saying we need more Haitians, I think it's perfectly okay for the president to ask the question to the person asking him, why do we need more Haitians? And we don't know what their response was. We do know the president said he did not say take them out. But on face value, for him to ask to the person, why do we need more, in a conversation about immigration, is not in itself racist. But the other comment, if they were said about the countries or about the countries' governments or how they were run, it's unfortunate. And like others have said, it's not helpful. And we've seen what this has done. So instead of talking about getting closer to a DACA fix or coming to the table or talking about the economy, we're talking about this comment. So clearly,
yeah, but that's
not
what the
helpful.
President said, right? That's what the president said. We wouldn't be talking about it if the president didn't call, if he didn't call African nations shitholes and didn't ask why we need more Haitians. And I think it's important to pair it with what came after that, the second fragment of the thought. Why do we need more Haitians? We should get more people from Norway, right?
Well, I think it's important for us to not to say that all of this was in one stream of consciousness, in one statement. We don't know that. But what we do know is that the president did meet with the president of Norway the day before, so that Norway was top of mind. And when you meet with a world leader, you go through all of the data, all of the statistics, the crime rate, the GDP, their economies, and all of those things. So I think that's why Norway was top of mind, because he had just met with the Norwegian president.
Okay.
So I think that's important to also note. But I'm not saying that. I just think we should just keep that in mind.
So let me play something for you from this is Isaac Newton Ferris Jr., Dr. King's nephew, who was at the event yesterday at the White House for Martin Luther King his weekend. He was certainly. Let's just play the soundbite and talk about it afterwards. What he said about the president.
Sure.
I don't think that President Trump is a racist in the traditional sense as we know in this country. I think President Trump is racially ignorant or racially uninformed. But I don't think that he's a racist in the traditional sense.
That doesn't really sound like an endorsement of the president. What's your reaction to that?
Well, first of all, I was at that event yesterday. I've known Isaac for about a decade, and I think he's a great person, because he actually reaches out and wanted to have the president involved and was with the president in Atlanta for the signing. I think he was here in Washington, D.C., and actually wanted to have the chairwoman of the Republican National Committee come to Atlanta, but couldn't get a hold of her. So he is the one who is a positive force in trying to reach out to not only this administration, but he did the same with the Bush administration, too. So to Isaac's point, look, I agree with him in saying that the president is not a racist, because he's not a racist.
But do you believe with the second half of that he is racially ignorant?
And the second half of that, I think the president is understanding now that he's having to deal with issues that he's never had to deal with before and deal with a lot of
He's understanding now. He should have understood that before he said, I'm running for president of the United States, right?
Well, listen, no president comes in here knowing every single thing. No president comes in having an understanding of every simple...
What's the evidence that he now understands that? Is the evidence that he called African nations shithole countries, or that maybe we don't need more Haitians? When you say now he's understanding that he's going to deal with a lot of issues, this is a president who's been on the job for 11 months now. How long do you need to not be in office, but be alive to know that 54 nations of Africa are not shitholes?
Well, I'll challenge you there. We don't know if there were specific countries named, and he responded about specific countries.
Are there specific shitholes in Africa?
What I'm saying is, if you talk about you can have an intellectual conversation without being a racist, comparing Nigeria, like your other guest did, and talking about the economy there, talked about the type of people who come here from Nigeria. They contribute to this nation, their education, how much more they make than white Americans, like she said, $10,000 more.
You certainly can
compare,
have that.
And you can compare them to other African countries that aren't doing so well.
But in what context do you call one of them a shithole?
Listen, I'm not here to defend that comment. I would not have used that comment. Many people can say and not be deemed racist or not being against the president, saying sometimes he says things or tweets things that aren't politically correct. Got it. Does not make him a racist. And you can have that intellectual conversation. And we should have that conversation.
So let me ask you this. You think that calling African countries shitholes is just politically incorrect?
I'm saying that the president can, at times, makes politically incorrect statements. I would not have said, used that language to describe certain African nations, if that's what was said.
You wouldn't have used it. It was wrong for the president to use it. Can you at least go that far?
I don't think that I would have used it. And I think
Paris,
the president...
I don't know that this is asking too much to ask you. Is it wrong for the president of the United States, and put aside your personal affinity for the man?
No, it's for
the
office.
Let me ask you about your respect for the office. Is it wrong for the president of the United States to call the 54 nations of an entire continent shitholes? That's a simple question.
I understand what you're trying to get me to do, but the notion that the president said that about all 54 nations is not true, and that would be wrong. Because as the other commentator talked about, Nigeria and the quality of the people that are coming here from Nigeria and what they contribute, that does not apply. So I don't think he was talking about them. So no, I don't think it was right to say that about use that phrase. But I do think it is perfectly okay and not racist to have an intellectual conversation when you're talking about immigration and making comparisons to say there are differences between one country and another country, one city in America and another city in America. The recovery in Mississippi versus the recovery in New Orleans based upon after Hurricane Katrina. You can do that and not be a racist. But I will say I would not have used it, and I don't think if that the president, seeing how this has panned out, would have used that, because what I was saying about what he's learning how to do and understanding is that as president, you can't say certain things.
Yes.
And you can't, and he's learning that because this is a new thing for him. And every president does
All
this.
Right.
Every president has it. But to say
Paris,
he's a racist is wrong.
Thank you so much.